Hey guys, it's Ishani, aka Total Makeup Junkie 101. So today we are going to be talking about a new eyeshadow palette that, I'm not gonna lie, I think most of us went into it thinking this product didn't need to exist. It just didn't need to exist. The first time I saw pictures of this palette, my initial instinct, like every part of my being told me, don't buy this. Don't buy it. You don't need it. What is another neutral palette doing on the market? And then the makeup junkie part of me came into play, and there's like that little, you know how you have an angel and a devil sitting on your shoulder, and the angel is like, Ishani, you don't need this palette. You have a million nude neutral palettes. And then the devil is yelling at me, no, 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 you are a makeup junkie. You are a YouTuber. Go at least swatch it. So I did. I went and swatched it. I threw it up on my Instagram stories and asked you guys if you wanted to see a review. Over half of you guys said yes. It was pretty split in the beginning, which I was a little surprised about, but the yes did win. And a part of me did kind of want to try the palette. So here we go. This is my review on the new Huda Beauty New Nude Palette. This palette retails for $65. You can pick it up anywhere that Huda Beauty is sold, like Sephora. I assume the Huda Beauty website. I don't know where else she sells, but I'm sure there are international distributors as well. Here's what the outer packaging of the palette looks like. It is quite pretty. This nude lettering is kind of iridescent. I don't know if the camera is picking that up. It does have this really cool, like, iridescent quality to it. And then the back of the palette has the ingredients and all of the details. JK, ingredients aren't on the palette. They are on the back of the box, however. The palette itself is held shut by a magnet. There is a pretty large mirror up at the top, and then you are getting 18 different products. The reason I say products is because not all of these are eyeshadows, and we'll talk about that throughout the review. There was also this little plastic sheet here covering the shadows. It's actually made of like really nice thick plastic. It's pretty. I'll probably throw it away, but it is pretty. As for some basic information about this palette, I'm gonna read the back of the unit carton here. It says, introducing the Huda Beauty New Nude Eyeshadow Palette, Huda's fresh take on a nude look. 18 gorgeous shades ranging from cool to warm tones, which, I don't know about that, including 10 buttery mattes that blend seamlessly with your skin, 4 multi-reflective shadows with a versatile pearly to iridescent finish, 2 pressed glitters for an opulent touch, 1 pressed pearl for a velvety shine, and 1 concealer base to make your shadows pop. So the way I'm gonna approach this review is not specifically critiquing the color scheme of this palette so much. You should know for yourself if you need another nude eyeshadow palette. This isn't a new concept to the market. We've seen neutral eyeshadow palettes for years. If you have yet to find your holy grail nude neutral eyeshadow palette, maybe this is something that'll catch your attention. At the end of the day, I didn't need this palette. I'll just be totally honest with you guys. I didn't need it. However, I do really, really like it. And I actually have been really enjoying using it. With that being said, this is not a perfect palette by any means whatsoever. I do have some critiques to make on this, but one of the critiques is not that it's a nude palette, because you're going into it knowing it's a nude palette. The bulk of this palette in terms of color scheme is a very cool toned, kind of mauvey, pinky toned nude palette. Before we talk about the textures of these shadows, let's go ahead and jump right into swatches of this entire palette so you can see how it looks against my skin tone. This is the first row in the palette swatched. From left to right, we have the shades Bare, Crave, Play, Fantasy, Love Bite, and Spanked. Here's the second row in the palette swatched. From left to right, we have Lace, Daydream, Tickle, Excite, Infatuated, and Kinky. And then here is the third row in the palette swatch. From left to right, we have Concealed, which is the concealer, so it is a creamy product. It's not a powder shadow. Secret, Tease, Raw, Charmed, and Teddy. Now discussing the different textures in this palette. First off, let's talk about the mattes. There are 10 matte shadows in this palette. The mattes are beautiful. They are so, so stunning. As you could see in the swatches, they swatch really, really beautifully. They're super creamy. They are quite powdery. The formula is pretty thin, so when you dip, especially a fluffy brush into them, you will get powder kick up. Honestly, I have no critiques with the mattes in this palette, from the lightest to the darkest. They all show up true to color and they all work amazingly. There is one pressed pearl in this palette, and that would be this shade over here. That shadow is going to be your pretty standard metallic eyeshadow. It's not super dense and super thick like a Makeup Geek foiled. It's a little thinner than that, but it still delivers a metallic pop across the eyes. It's a really beautiful shade. I wouldn't say it's the standout in this palette, but it performs perfectly fine. I don't have any issues with that color. I can pick it up with my brush. I can pick it up with my finger. It just works amazingly. There are two pressed glitters in this palette. That would be these two shades right here. Let's talk about this for a quick second. I'm gonna just close this palette up because I have a little bit to say. With the amount of new makeup formulations and new makeup products coming out, the liquid glitter eyeshadow trend is still here. There are so many companies that do liquid glitter eyeshadows, like the Stila Glitter and Glow. I know ColourPop has their Supernova eyeshadows. I know BH Cosmetics has a version, and those are approximately a bajillion times easier to use than a glitter that is pressed in a palette. I mean, I understand if she was maybe trying to do something different, because not a lot of companies do pressed glitter in a palette. And guys, when I mean pressed glitter, like, this is straight up glitter. This is not a super, super glittery shadow with a base color. This is chunky, sand-like, gritty glitter with a clear base pressed into a pan that you then have to either pick up with your finger, but then you can't blend around it because you'll just get a ton of glitter fallout. It's gonna be a pain in the butt to clean up. Honestly, nobody needed these. These didn't need to be in the palette. So another product I kind of wish was just not there is this concealer. This light white creamy colored concealer. Not gonna look like a concealer on my skin tone, let me tell you that. I personally don't like creamy products next to powder products in the same palette, because when you use the powders, especially since these mattes are so powdery, they do give a lot of kick up. That powder will over time transfer into the concealer, so your concealer is gonna get tinted with whatever colored powders start falling into it, and then it's just gonna be unusable. Also, that concealer is probably gonna dry out quicker than you can even use this palette up, so it just seems to be an unnecessary product. Again, wish she would have just left that out. However, there is one part of the palette, besides the mattes are stunning. These multi-reflective shadows is what she calls them. There are four of them. There's these two, this one, and this one. Those shadows, if you look up close at them, they almost look like pressed foil pigment infused with specks, or almost like marbleized with specks of opalescent pearl. Honestly, when I saw the tester on the display, I thought that those little white iridescent particles were almost like hard pan forming on the shadow. So my initial instinct was, okay, as you use this product, it's gonna start getting this weird white hard pan, and it's almost gonna look like there's like mold or fungus or something growing in it. Once I realized that's how the shadows are supposed to be, and it's not mold or fungus, and it's also not hard pan, it is genuinely marbleized. These really interesting, almost like duochrome iridescent white pearls blended into these base colors. The formula is dense, so it's best to pick these up with your fingers. You can use stiffer brushes, but you will get quite a bit of fallout if you try to use these with a brush. I do think the opalized marble pearl type thing does actually do something really unique to the shadow. It's not just a flat, you know, foil champagne, foil taupe, foil copper, foil bronze. Like, you do have this really interesting twist. So out of the 18 pans of product that you get here, honestly, I think 15 of them are knockouts. Everything besides the concealer, which I just honestly didn't think needed to be there at all, and the two pressed glitter shadows, which you can totally get them to work, but again, they really didn't need to be here. If I wanted to use a glitter, there are a million other easier ways to do it. Okay, so now I'm gonna do some side-by-sides with a couple of really popular eyeshadow palettes on the market. I just wanted to show you how they compared. When I initially saw the kind of mauve-y, light pinky purple color scheme to this palette, I really thought of the Urban Decay Naked 3 palette. This palette, in my opinion, was kind of the original light pink neutral palette, at least the original one that I had in my collection. And looking at them here side by side, you can see that the Urban Decay palette on the bottom actually looks quite a bit more brown and maybe even a little bit more taupey than the Huda palette. The Huda palette pulls a lot more pink, in my opinion. And I do feel like there's just more shades, more versatile shades than you get in the Naked 3. Now, when I saw that Naked 3 wasn't really as close of a dupe as I thought it was going to be, I immediately thought of Naked Cherry. This is the newest Urban Decay Naked palette, and it is that nude, pinky, mauve-y, purpley color scheme. And here you can see them side by side. I definitely think Naked Cherry is a lot more similar to the new nude palette than Naked 3 was. You do have quite a bit more reddish, burgundy, or like the purpley tones that the Huda palette has. And then the final side by side I wanted to do, this palette isn't super comparable, but it was, in my opinion, the most comparable Anastasia palette. It's the Soft Glam palette. And here we have those two compared. You can see that the Anastasia palette is sort of like a condensed down version of the Huda palette. You have a little bit more versatility in the Anastasia palette because you're getting a dark matte brown and a dark matte black. So the Anastasia palette can definitely go from day to night really easily. The Huda palette, because you're not getting any insanely dark matte colors, you're not gonna go that smoky or dark with it. And that would probably be my final critique about the Huda palette, is that the darkest color you're getting is this Love Bite shade, which, don't get me wrong, I've used that shade in every single look that I've done with this palette, and I love it. But I think if the concealer was replaced by a dark, cool-toned brown, that would have added even more versatility to this palette. Again, I understand why she didn't include any super dark colors in this palette, because it is supposed to be a nude, neutral palette. But I think just for the sake of versatility, one single dark matte color would have really changed the game with this palette just a little bit. Alrighty guys, finishing up this review with a couple of housekeeping things. This palette is made in Italy. In terms of the amount of product, you are getting 19.7 grams of product total in this palette. That means that you're getting about 1.1 grams per pan. That means that you're paying $3.30 per gram for the products in this palette. That's definitely on the higher end side of a price per gram, but it's not obscenely high. I mean, the Anastasia palettes, you're paying over $4 per gram. So these are even more expensive per gram. If you are in the market for another nude, kind of cool toned, pinky toned palette, which is very different from all the warm toned and orange toned nude palettes we've been seeing, this is really pretty. I really do love this palette and I will continue using it. I'm a fan. Alrighty guys, so there we have it. That is my full review on the Huda Beauty new nude palette. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you guys have your eyes on this palette, let me know in the comments down below, or if you've already picked it up, let me know your thoughts. I'd love to hear from you. Thank you so much for your continued love and support on my channel. I really, really appreciate it, and I will see you guys in my next video on Monday. I'll see you then. Bye.